This is part 5 of solving linear equations. We're going to be going over the multiplication property of equality, which says if A, B, and C are numbers and C is not equal to 0, then A equals B and AC equals BC are equivalent equations. What that says is if you have two things that are equal, you could multiply both sides of the equation by the same number, as long as that number is not 0, and get the same solutions. Let's say there's a variable involved. Now, also, if A equals B and A over C equals B over C are equivalent equations, that's saying you could divide the same non-zero number by both sides of the equations and keep the solutions at the same. All right, so here's an example. 5x equals negative 35. So this is 5 times something equals negative 35. What you really want to do is undo what was multiplied by x, because you want to know what just x equals. So what I could do is just divide both sides by 5. Something was multiplied by x, so if I divide both sides, something was multiplied by 5, sorry. So if I divide both sides by 5, what happens is the 5's cancel, right? So that I can say that x equals, and what do we have over here? Negative 35 divided by 5 is negative 7. Now, again, this is something a lot of you could do in your head, 5x equals negative 35, but we want to understand it on an easy problem so we can do the answer on another one. So let's say we're going to check this answer. Is it true that negative 7 is the answer? You would put in negative 7 for x. Simplify the left-hand side using the order operations. And since you did get the same answer, x equals negative 7 is the correct answer. And of course, you could write that as either negative 7, or you could use your braces. That's the formal way of writing a solution. So I'm just going to box it to say either way, it's correct. So here's another problem, negative 9x equals negative 15. So this is very different than negative 9 plus x. This is negative 9 times x. So if we divide both sides by negative 9, notice it's not the opposite sign. You don't add 9. You don't divide by positive 9. You want to make sure it completely cancels when you divide. So you need to divide by the coefficient of x. Negative 9 is the coefficient. So that will give me, this will cancel completely to 1x, which is x. And now what do we have over here? We have a negative divided by a negative. So the answer is positive, but you also need to reduce. What number goes into both 15 and 9? 3. So that's going to be 5/3. And it's perfectly okay to leave your answer as an improper fraction, 5/3. Or if you'd prefer, you can write it as 1 2/3. But it's unnecessary to do that. You do not want to write it as a decimal because it doesn't go in evenly. So you could write also your answer as 5/3, that's the answer, or in solution braces. Okay, let's check. So you write down the original problem, 9x equals negative 15. And we're going to plug in, and you'll see why I want to leave it as 5/3. It's easier to plug in if I just write in 5/3 as opposed to 1 2/3. Because if you write in 1 2/3, you're going to have to change it to 5/3 to multiply. So I'm going to write this as negative 9 over 1, okay? And I'm going to plug in 5/3 for x. Now, you could write negative 45/3 and then do long division, or you could cancel to get the answer. But this is going to reduce, no matter how you do it, to negative 15. There's one negative sign, so I'm going to leave it to you how you go from there. I like reducing things, so I would probably just do the 1. But remember that minus sign is still there, and that's how I would get 3 times 5, or 15, but with a minus sign. And you don't want to leave it as negative 15 over 1, because any number divided by 1 is just the numerator. On the right-hand side, it's negative 15. And so there you go. Here's a problem with a fraction. Now, you could divide by 2/5, but it's a little more complicated. I'm going to show you what you could do, and then show you the easy way to do it. You could say, well, I got 2/5 times x. To undo it, I'll just divide both sides by 2/5. right? But you got to divide both sides by 2/5. Now you have a nice, yucky, complex fraction. So it's true that the 2/5 cancels with the 2/5, and I'll get x equals, but this side's a little bit messy. It'll still work out, though, because what that really means is 30 divided by 2/5. And then division with fractions, I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal. So 30 times 5/2, and then you'd have to cancel. And finally, you do get 75, which I think is the correct answer. Let's go ahead and check it. 2/5 equals 30. You write the problem down. Plug in 75 for x. And then go ahead and cancel if you can. Or you can multiply and say that's 150 over 5. I'll do that this time just to show you that's okay, if you prefer. And that reduces to 30. Okay, so 75 is the answer. It's a little bit messy dividing a fraction by a fraction because of this multiplying with the reciprocal. So I'm going to do the same problem a little bit differently now. So we have 2/5 x equals 30. 2/5 x equals 30. Now, another way to find out what x is if I just multiply by the reciprocal of 2/5 in the first place, it'll cancel. So what if I took, instead of dividing by 2/5, remember what dividing by 2/5 is? It's the same thing as multiplying by 5/2. But if you multiply the left side by 5/2, you have to multiply the right side by 5/2. And you can see the 2's cancel, the 5's cancel. 1, 1, 1, 1. So I get x equals, the 2 goes into 30. You still get 15. The check looks exactly the same, but notice I did the problem a little bit differently. So here how it really took like one extra line to get the answer. And notice the way we did it a minute ago, it were those few steps. Again, it's up to you. Okay, we're going to do this one more way. There's a little trick anytime you have fractions to get rid of fractions before you try solving the equation. So what you notice is there's a fraction, and you look and see, look for any denominators. In this case, there's one denominator, it's 5, so that's the least common denominator. And what you do is you multiply both sides of the equation by the least common denominator. So you would multiply both sides of the equation by 5. Now, I like to do this by putting a big bracket around the whole equation, and I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by 5. So I have to multiply it on both sides by 5. Some people like to write that as just 5 times 2/5 x equals 5 times 30. If you prefer to do that instead of showing it the way I've done it up here, it gives you exactly the same thing. So what do we get? Well, the 5's will cancel. And notice what happens. I get a problem without fractions. So that's a trick to do for a first step if you don't want to deal with any fractions, and then now use the multiplication or division property. So now we're going to divide both sides by 2, and we're still going to get the answer of 75. So we got answer of 75 one more time, and it checked, because we already checked it way up here, remember? There was the check. Okay. So when you're dealing with fractions, you do have more than one possible way of solving. Okay, here's another problem, and we could solve this a couple different ways. First, let's just multiply by the reciprocal of -5/8, which would be -8/5. Remember, you have to take the same sign because you want it to completely cancel out. So I could multiply both sides by -5/8. Let me move this over here so we have a little more room. You have to do this on your page. Make sure you do it. So if I multiply both sides by -8/5, what you're trying to do is cancel everything so you just get 1x. Remember, instead of dividing by -5/8, remember that's the same thing as multiplying by -8/5. And then what happens here? This all cancels to just x exactly what we want. And we look to see if there's anything to cancel over here. And yes, 2 goes into both of those numbers. So we've got the minus sign still, -4/15. Okay, I'm not going to do the check right now. I'm going to show you the second way I showed you. -5/8x = 1/6. You multiply by the least common denominator, which is 24. 8 and 6, 24 go into both. Those both go into 24. So I have 24 times -5/8x = 24 times 1/6. And now what you need to do is cancel. And you get a problem without any fractions. Now you could divide by -15. And you have the same answer. x = -4/15. And I don't have time for the check. Have fun.
I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.